knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men. The shadow knows.
Good evening, and thank you for tuning in to the Wright Opera House and Ouray County Players production of The Shadow. Tonight's episode is brought to you by High Country Leathers, Mark Hitchcocks of United Country Snuffles Realty, Ouray T-shirts and Mementos, and Barbara and Larry Meckle. Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men? The Shadow knows. A figure never seen, only heard, the Shadow is really Lamont Cranston, who, years ago in the Orient, learned the hypnotic power to cloud men's minds so that they cannot see him. Cranston's friend, Margot Lane, is the only person who knows to whom the voice of the invisible shadow belongs. Tonight's episode, The Red Macaw, was the second broadcast of The Shadow and originally aired on October 3rd, 1937. We will begin in just a moment, but first...
Do you long for great schools, a peaceful pace of life, clear air and water, and almost no crime? If so, it's high time you make the move to the western slope of Colorado. United Country Snuffles Realty is the top-selling office in Ouray County and serves Montrose, San Juan, and San Miguel counties. Let Mark Hitchcock select the right mountain property, agricultural estate, or mining claim of your dreams. Call or text Mark at 970-729-3055 today and make a change for the better.
And now, the Wright Opera House and Ouray County Players present The Shadow.
The Master speaks. Attention, ladies. The spirit of Shiva is upon us. Quiet.
Put your hands up, all of you.
Men, I have a very important announcement to make to all members of the police department this morning. I have become convinced that the man responsible for the crime wave sweeping our city is a character who is known as the Shadow. I have issued a warrant for his arrest, and I want him brought to justice. Who's that? Riley, who's that laughing?
I don't know, sir. Nobody seems to know.
The Shadow knows.
Lamont Cranston, the police have got a warrant out for the Shadow.
Really, Miss Lane?
Listen, Lamont, dear, you've played the role of the Shadow for 5 years. You've driven a large part of the underworld out of business.
And... Yes, and there's still a large part yet to be driven out of business. You know, Margot, sometimes I suspect there's one controlling mind behind organized crime in this city. One master criminal. I'm certain of it, in fact. Someday I'll find that man. Perhaps then we can talk of quitting.
But, Lamont, you can't fight the underworld and the police, too. You mean too much to me, and it must not happen. You must let the Shadow stop for my sake, Lamont, please.
Someday, perhaps, Margot. But, my dear, the Shadow still has too much work to do. About the little piece of playfulness on the part of the police, this warrant for a man they've never seen and can't identify, it interests me. I think, if you don't mind my leaving you so abruptly, I think I'll take a run over to the Cobalt Club. It's just about the time my very good friend, Police Commissioner Ralph Weston, usually has a cocktail there.
Hello there, Cranston. Have a cocktail?
Hello, Weston. Don't mind if I do. A dry martini. Well, how's the police department? Anything of special import preying on the mastermind nowadays?
Well, nothing we can't deal with.
How delightful. There are so many things in life I feel myself incompetent to deal with.
When you feel like that, you can always pay someone else to do the job. That's the advantage of being a millionaire.
I have often consoled myself with the same thought. By the way, didn't I hear that there was a jewel robbery at the Chathams last night?
Cranston, if I permitted anything to bother me, it would be the series of jewel robberies this fall. 3 in a row. Fortunately, we have our man. Or rather, we know who he is.
My dear man, you are infallible, positively infallible.
It's the Shadow. We've got a warrant out for him now.
You have a warrant out for a Shadow?
Not a Shadow, Cranston. The Shadow.
So, he's the one that staged those 3 jewel robberies, eh?
Yes, I'm inclined to believe he is.
Amazing. Who put you on his track?
Well, we've had a pretty hard time of it, although there were plenty of witnesses at these robberies. They all took place at parties, you know, and most of the guests were women.
Go on.
Well, we never could seem to get a coherent story out of them. None of them could seem to tell us just what happened. Acted almost as if they'd been hypnotized. Finally, we found one man, highly intelligent, and he made the suggestion.
And who is this brilliant intellect?
His name is Ram Lal. Poses as a mystic, occultism, wisdom of the East, all that sort of thing. Been educated in the best Egyptian universities.
Ah, yes, I believe I've heard of him.
You must have. Terribly popular. Goes to all the fashionable parties. The women are mad about him. Pretends to be a magician or something. Goes everywhere with a big red bird who talks. It really says the most amazing things.
I see. The police are now taking orders from a talking bird, eh?
Don't be silly. Ram Lal is a brilliant man. When we questioned him, he said that it was obvious from the way these robberies were accomplished that no ordinary crook was at the bottom of it. In fact, there was only one criminal with the finesse, the occult ability to confuse witnesses, who could be responsible. And he is the great, almost supernatural magician, detective and criminal, the Shadow. And I think Ram Lal is right. It all hangs together. The lack of clues, the witnesses who can't remember a thing, the strange, unkind methods used, all point to a master criminal intelligence. So this time, we're going to get the Shadow.
You sound very determined, Weston. I'm glad you're not trailing me.
Well, Cranston, what would you do if you were the Shadow?
If I were the Shadow, I think I'd have a heart-to-heart talk with this magician colleague, Ram Lal.
This radio show is brought to you by the fine outfitters at High Country Leathers, local haberdashers since 1989, providing the latest vestments and attire for all your mountain living needs. Whether you are kicking a mule up a trail to your mining claim or accompanying your partner to an outing at the latest Ride Opera House event, High Country Leathers will see you there in style. Find them on Main Street in beautiful downtown Ouray. That's High Country Leather in Ouray. And don't forget to mask up.
Ram Lal.
Who calls?
It is I, Ram Lal.
And who are you? I am alone here.
The Shadow.
Ah, the Shadow. Welcome to my humble abode, dear master.
You've heard of me, I see.
But certainly. Who has not heard of the Shadow? That comic strip. That joke for children.
Ram Lal, you have falsely accused me, and I do not easily forget or forgive.
No? And just what do you expect to do about it?
You choose to defy me?
Of course.
Ram Lal, you are a fool.
There are those who will not agree with you, and now, if you have finished, I must continue my devotion.
I have not finished. I will never have finished, Ram Lal, until I have brought your downfall.
And how do you propose to do that?
There is no knowledge of the ancient world, no science of the modern, that I will not bring against you.
Really? What does any Occidental know of the wisdom of the East? And as for your pompous modern science, bah! I have studied that too. You can prove nothing without witnesses, and the women who are my followers, they will not talk about me. They cannot. I have rendered them powerless.
Perhaps I can give them back their power, Ram Lal. Somewhere, you have left something undone, some loose end, that I will find. After that, it will be easy.
I shall await that discovery with delightful anticipation.
I rather think, Ram Lal, you will not have to wait too long.
The fog is heavy on the river tonight, Miss Lane. The ships are calling to each other like lost souls.
Your view over the Hudson is very beautiful, Ram Lal. It was kind of you to let me come and see it with you.
I am only happy to enjoy it, Miss Lane.
Not everyone has the privilege of being the guest of the Master of Mystery.
You're very flattering.
Not at all. By the way, speaking of mysteries, I can't help wondering about the great silent bird of yours that sits on his perch between the windows. It looks at me with such blank, staring eyes.
Ah, yes, my Red Macaw. You like him?
A macaw. He's gorgeous, but so silent.
Silent? You think so?
Well, he hasn't made a sound so far.
That is because he is a good servant. He waits for orders.
Whose orders?
Mine, and only mine.
You mean he won't speak for anybody else?
Exactly.
Well, may I try him?
With pleasure.
What is his name?
Harine.
Harine? What time is it? Do you know?
You see, he waits for me. Answer the lady, Harine.
Ha! 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 Ha!
5. And it's just 5 o'clock. That is wonderful. But can he really talk, Ramlal? Pronounce words?
Most certainly. Harine, what is the end of life?
Death.
And what is the end of death?
Life.
Incredible! Do you teach him the answers, Ramlal?
What do I need to teach? He knows.
Well, will you ask him just one question for me?
If you like.
What is it that casts a shadow and yet is only a shadow?
Answer, Harine.
Satan!
The shadow of a shadow. I wonder.
Tell me, Miss Lane, why did you ask that question?
Why, I hardly know.
You had no particular purpose?
Why, of course not. Why should I?
You lie, Margot Lane. You have come here as a spy.
How dare you speak like that? Open the door. I'm going home.
You are going nowhere until you have answered my questions. Come here, Miss Lane.
Don't. Don't you touch me.
I know how to deal with women. Who turned off the lights? Answer me.
The door is open, Miss Lane. Go. You will be quite safe.
Gladly.
The shadow. So, it's you again. I might have known. Why do you not reveal yourself so that we may meet face to face?
I am here, Ramlal, in the corner.
So, this time I am prepared for you.
Ramlal, your Hindu magic should have told you. You cannot shoot a shadow.
Before we return to the shadow, let me tell you folks all about Uray t-shirts and mementos.
This presentation of The Shadow is brought to you by Uray T-Shirts and Mementos. Pop on in to Uray T-Shirts and Mementos for a unique selection of high-quality T-shirts and gifts. Whether you need a present for Grandpa or you're shopping for your little ankle biter of a nephew, Uray T-Shirts and Mementos has something for everyone. While you're at it, treat yourself to something swell. Located at 612 Main Street, that's Uray T-Shirts and Mementos, serving Uranians and Turanians since 2014.
And now, back to the Red Macaw as the Shadow seeks Miss Lane's assistance.
Margot, a Red Macaw can't talk. Get me a list of all women under the influence of Ramlal. Stand by for Ovelius.
Miss Lane is a spy. A spy for the police, Sultra.
Then she must die, Master.
Yes, she must die. And you, a servant of Shiva, a master of death by the noose, should know how.
Tell me where she lives, Master. Tomorrow she will be dead, gasping for air.
It is well.
Why did you insist on coming home with me tonight, Lamont?
My dear, I have a curious feeling that you are in danger.
But why?
After all, Ramlal suspects you and... Did you hear that?
Of course. What was it? A nightbird?
A nightbird here in New York? Well, perhaps. There it is again. Where would you say it came from?
From just outside my window. It couldn't be anything but a bird. This is the top floor.
I really think this extraordinary bird merits my attention.
What are you going to do with that revolver?
It may put me on a more equal term with that bird who cries. Listen carefully, Margot. I'm going to open the window and lean out. When I do so, hold on to my belt. Brace yourself and hold with all your weight. Pull me back, you understand?
Lamont, I'm frightened.
You needn't be. Now then, ready? Here goes the window up. Now I'll lean out to see what is making that cry.
Lamont! Lamont, are you hurt?
No, darling. Throat rather sore, that's all.
But what was it? What happened? I couldn't see.
An Indian strangler on the roof. I knew the call. It's the call of Shiva. Used by those who kill with a noose. He used that cry to get me to the window. Thought it was you, of course, and dropped his noose.
I got him before he got me, fortunately.
But what does it mean?
Simply a delicate attention from Ram Lal to you.
The man must be mad. You said he was clever.
He's mad with fear, that's all. Until this man is unmasked, you're not safe. So we'll pretend that his little ruse tonight was successful. You'll go into hiding here in your own house. Tomorrow the papers will have the story of your untimely end. I'll arrange for that.
But Lamont!
Please, darling, do as I ask. It'll only be for a little while.
But when do I come to life again?
The Roger Berkeleys are giving a party tomorrow night, aren't they?
Yes, the invitation came last week. Ram Lal will be there.
You will go to that party.
But what will everyone say? I mean, if my death has been just announced.
The greater shock, the better. Ram Lal is going to be there, of course.
I know he will. Betty Berkeley told me.
Good. Your appearance there ought to make Ram Lal believe in miracles. Margot, something tells me that tomorrow night we'll clear the name of the shadow. But I'll have to act quickly from now on.
What are you going to do?
I'm not sure what Lamont Cranston, well-known playboy and dilettante, is going to do. But somebody else knows that you must fight fire with fire. The shadow is going to give a seance.
Ladies, please give me your attention. I know that all of you have been under the influence of Ram Lal.
Why, where is he? I don't see anybody.
I'm scared.
Well, I'm not.
I have come to you in this way, ladies, because I wish to demonstrate to you that matter can not only be materialized, but that it can be dematerialized also. I am a voice, no more. Look around the room. It is not large. You will not see me, yet I am here.
Oh, I don't like this at all.
Be quite calm, dear. It's only a fake of some kind. Any yogi could do it if he wished.
If it is a fake, your highly intelligent minds should quickly uncover it. And speaking of fakes, I know that you all, every one of you, have been under the influence of that prince of all fakes, Ram Lal.
Didn't I tell you?
Don't worry, my dear.
I wish I hadn't come.
You have nothing to fear. I bring you knowledge. Knowledge that has been hard bought by years of training under the greatest mystics of the earth. Before I give you my message, I must know how greatly, if at all, your minds have been distorted from the truth by Ram Lal's teaching. You do not believe? Will you submit to a simple, harmless test?
No test will shake us. We have complete confidence in Ram Lal.
Very well. Attention, I turn out the lights. Look at the end of the room. There is a wheel upon the wall, and on the wheel are electric lights of various colors. You see them?
Certainly.
Good. Watch them closely as the wheel revolves. Ready?
Perfectly ready. Of course, it's cheap trickery.
I throw the switch. The wheel revolves. Keep your eyes fastened on it. Leave your minds free. Empty them of all error. Watch the wheel revolve. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it. The lights have blended into one. You can see nothing else. Your minds are open to me. I can see your thoughts. I can see your thoughts. Mrs. Fowler, listen.
Yes?
You were at all three parties where jewel robberies took place this autumn, were you not?
Yes, I was.
And Ram Lal, with his Red Macaw, was at all of them too, wasn't he?
Yes, he was.
Now concentrate. Divest your soul of all error. And now let me see your mind. Tell me the last thing that happened before the masked thieves came into the room.
The Red Macaw was asked a question.
Ah, and what was that question?
Ram Lal asked it. He asked, what was beneath the light?
And what was the answer of the Red Macaw?
The shadow. The shadow.
The shadow.
Hello, Police Commissioner Weston speaking. Who is this?
The shadow.
Hey, what is this, a joke? The shadow wouldn't dare call me up. There's a warrant out for him now.
I'm not taking that seriously, Commissioner.
You will when I serve it.
You mean I will if you serve it?
I'm not worried about that.
I will give you something else to worry about. You may know that the Roger Berkeleys are giving a small party tonight.
Certainly I know it. So what?
The fourth in the series of jewel robberies will be committed there. Are you interested?
Try to pull that. I'll surround the house and have a raiding party ready to break in at any minute.
Excellent. I could not ask for more. And if you wish to choose the right minute for the raid, you will wait for the signal.
What signal?
The signal given by the Red Macaw. When he mentions my name, that is the signal. Remember, the shadow.
So glad you could come tonight, Lamont. I was afraid this fearful news about Margot Lane might keep you away.
My dear Betty, nothing could keep me away from one of your parties.
So sweet of you. I think you know everybody here. Oh, have you met Rom Lal?
No, I haven't had the pleasure.
Oh, Rom Lal, I want to present Lamont Cranston.
Charmed, I'm sure, Mr. Cranston.
How do you do? I've heard quite a lot about you. Sometime I'd like to see your famous bird.
Rom Lal is showing off his red macaw for us tonight. Aren't you, Rom Lal?
I am to have that pleasure, I believe.
I would very much like to meet that bird. I hear amazing things about it.
The Mystic East is full of the unexpected.
Quiet, please. We are to have a most unusual pleasure tonight. Rom Lal has brought his red macaw and has promised that it will answer questions.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to present to you Harine, the sacred red macaw. Harine, you will answer the question I ask. Now.
Good evening, everybody.
Good heavens. Margot Lane.
Yes, the reports of my death were somewhat exaggerated, but I didn't mean to interrupt. You were about to listen to the Red Macaw as I came in. Please, continue, Rom Lal.
I cannot. I am ill.
Evening, Margot, old thing. If Rom Lal is indisposed, do you mind, I wonder, if I can do anything with the Red Macaw?
You are absurd. He will not, cannot speak for you.
You'll be surprised, Rom Lal. Harine. Who is your master?
You are!
I protest at this farce. It's
one more question, Rom Lal. Harine, what is under the light?
The shadow!
A lie, a cheat!
Is it? Wait, dear master.
Lift your hand, all of you. This is a stick-up.
Get him, boys.
Drop that gun, you.
What is this, Rom Lal, a trap?
Yes, no, I do not know.
I don't know you.
Oh, you don't, huh? Well, take this. I got him, Chief. I'm going to call the three others outside.
Good. Take him to headquarters.
Okay. Come on, you.
Wait a minute, Riley. Take this one, too.
Keep away from me.
This Rom Lal guy?
Certainly. He's the leader. He tried to put me off the track.
Okay. Come on. Get going.
He's someone else, too. Unless I'm very much mistaken.
This presentation of The Shadow is brought to you by Barbara and Larry Meckel, Ouray residents since 1970. Barbara and Larry Meckel are staples of our beautiful community. The retired geologists and travelers are avid supporters of the arts. Ouray County players would like to thank Barbara and Larry Meckel for their continued support of the Ride Opera House. It's patrons like the Meckels that make this program possible.
But Lamont, the macaw. It talked.
No, it didn't. Rom Lal talked for it. Simple ventriloquism, that's all. And it just so happens, I'm as good a ventriloquist as Rom Lal.
Oh, Lamont, you're marvelous.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have a surprise for you. It is one of the most satisfactory discoveries of my whole career in crime detection. You know the man taken here tonight as Rom Lal. His real name is The Shadow. Yes, and for once, the laugh is on him. What was that?
You're wrong, Commissioner. You've got Rom Lal, the jewel thief, but the Shadow has the last laugh.
You have just heard one of the many dramatized versions of The Shadow. This episode, The Red Macaw, originally aired October 3rd, 1937, and is presented to you by the Wright Opera House and Ouray County Players. Starring Mark Hitchcox as The Shadow, Lamont Cranston, Kate Jones as Margot Lane, Dan Preston as Rom Lal and Hareem, the Macaw, John Morris as Commissioner Weston, Glenn Williams as Officer Riley, Nancy Nixon as Maud Fowler, Alisa Preston as Ruth, Marsha Lee Brahms as Betty Berkeley, and this is Caleb Preston, your announcer, reading his Sultra. Thank you for listening to tonight's radio show and for supporting the arts in Ouray County and beyond.